it could have been so different for not even just South Africa, the whole, sorry, it's not even Ghana, but the whole of Africa seemed to be behind them at that stage. And the setting of the World Cup, just an absolute amazing location. The things in this country is just unreal.
Yeah. I think the Italy game that we went to, how many did we go to?
15,
yeah. So we went to 15 games in total, just seeing all the different players. I don't know how many teams we saw in total. Different teams?
20 or 21.
21 different teams. Obviously, another lasting memory is England being rubbish, but it's not a great one. Not seeing Messi score was disappointing. But
and your boy Torres.
Torres, yeah, not turning up, not doing anything good at all, just not even being able to pass the ball. But just seeing some players that sort of surprised me, like Honda and so on. Arsene Wenger thinks he's a genius. Not sure I agree with him that much, but
Hamzik at Slovakia.
Yeah.
And half the Slovenian team, or most of the Slovenian team, we knew about three players before we came away. I think we'd be quite happy if either of our team had a couple of them in there now, the way they passed and moved.
Yeah.
Which England would learn.
The Blanco penalty for Mexico, where he just did the most ridiculous run up and then put it into the side of the net. Really placed it. I thought he was going to hammer it. But I
think the best memory though would be the opening game, and just when South Africa scored that first goal, Shabalala. Absolute amazing drive.
Yeah, it was brilliant.
And the place just erupted.
Yeah.
Superb.
Lots of hugs from the locals.
High fives from like some 90-year-old lady sitting behind us. Just
dancing, everything.
Absolutely brilliant.
My name is Alketi. I'm Albanian and I live in Canada. I came here to South Africa a week ago. Stay here for a week. This is my second World Cup experience. I was in Germany in 2006. And stay there for 2 weeks. My pre-impression about South Africa was that it was a nice country, and it proved it right. I had the time of my life. It was a really beautiful experience. I watched the semi-final, Germany against Spain. Unfortunately, Germany lost. I watched the final, Netherlands against Spain. That was one of the best memories of my life. I got to meet lots of people from UK, people from Malta, people from Denmark, US, and all over the world. It was really such a great experience. Johannesburg, it's a great city. I was in Durban for 3 days. That was a very, very beautiful city. I hope I can go back one day. Overall, it's been a beautiful experience. South Africa is a great country, and I think the whole world should come and visit the country. It's been one of the best experiences of my life, and it's been one of the best times of my life. I love South Africa. I enjoyed my time over here. God bless South Africa. Yeah. Back to the program. Here with the ghetto spokesman. We don't sell dope, we sell hope. That's right. I also got Tracy D with me. And my name is Stormy.
You know, I'd like to think that people came here and they saw a multicultural society of people, just all of us just having fun and celebrating. And, you know, that kind of spirit of unity is what we're always talking about in South Africa, the Rainbow Nation, and being together as one and celebrating and moving forward and working together. It's togetherness, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah. That for South Africa is the dream.
Yeah. Okay.
And, well, yeah, like I said before, we've never really had that kind of feeling before. You know, you can go to certain parts of South Africa and you find that the way people live is still very segregated, even though it's 16 years after apartheid. You know, we've 16 years of democracy, we still live in our little segregated spaces, and we come out during the day and maybe we mix with other people in our work, or on the streets or in shops, but generally we don't party together and we don't celebrate together, and this World Cup has really just brought people out of those places and given them a reason to be excited together about the same thing.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
In general, what you see on TV, the games were fantastic, the sport was fantastic, the country was brought together by a round ball and a big lump of plastic called the vuvuzela. This did bring some national pride together. People of colour shared transport for the first time, possibly, shared life experiences going into areas such as Soweto they'd never seen before, and in general, the man in the street found the event quite fortuitous and a wonderful experience. I hope that our roads and infrastructure might now be prepared and resurfaced and redone, seeing as all the funding that seemed to go towards the 2010 building of stadiums could not accommodate the basic services of rubbish removal, the servicing of suburbs with lighting and security, that some of the potholes that are causing grievous harm to cars around the country can possibly be filled, and we can hope that the swift action seen at the soccer courts could maybe be brought into play in everyday life. Possibly this would bring down South Africa's image as being the murder capital of the world, and we could actually start putting a handle on the crime that is rampant in the area. We hope as well that future guests will come here, realizing although they may have been ripped off by certain establishments as restaurants and bookings for planes and hotels, the prices were exorbitant, but I hope they enjoyed this day to realize that this is not always the case and will return to have many good holidays.
が無事成功したら南アフリカの信頼というものが高まるはずなので、それはもうアフリカを愛する僕としてはとっても嬉しいことなんです。でただ同時に、残念だったこともいくつかあって、それは、日本のメディアの人たちを見ているとホテルとスタジアムの往復しかどうやらしていないようでした。で彼らは、おそらく日本人の旅行者よりも南アフリカのことを怖がっていると未だに思います。なので、彼らサッカーの試合をしてくれを取材するのは当然なんですけれど、もっともっと南アフリカのことを取材してほしかったと僕はそういうふうに感じています。それから、ワールドカップの外に目を向けてみると、なかなかワールドカップの恩恵を得られる人が決して多くはないということもやはり見えてきます。南アフリカで今回9都市で、試合が開かれていますけれど、どこも大きな都市ばかりです。でたくさんの人がやってきて、たくさんのビジネスチャンスが生まれていることは事実ですけれど、だけどそれはもうすでに何か、ビジネスをしている人たちにとってのビジネスチャンスです。それは例えば宿を経営していたり、ホテルをやっていたり、タクシーのドライバーだったり、でもそういった仕事をしてない人にとっては、何もワールドカップから得られるものはないことも事実、そしてワールドカップの試合を見に行くことは、彼らにとってはほとんど不可能です。なぜならば彼らは月に3000ランドぐらいしかお金を稼ぐことができていませんから。だから、南アフリカの全ての人たちがワールドカップから何かを得ているっていうのは、ちょっとそれは思い過ごしだよなというふうに、改めて感じました。で、僕は28日にプレトリアに来てから、 あ、ワールドカップの外にいる人たちを見たくて、それでリンポポというあの南アフリカの一番北のところに行きました。そこには、水道はギリギリありましたけれど、トイレは水洗ではないし、もう本当に小さい小さい村です。でやはりそこの人たちとワールドカップの話をしても、まあワールドカップねというぐらいで、特にワールドカップで盛り上がっているという感じではありませんでした。でも、彼らと話していても思ったし、僕も感じたのは、具体的にお金っていうものが得られなかったとしても、ワールドカップが開かれたことで、南アフリカの人たちが多くの外国人と触れる、きっかけというかチャンスができたことは、僕は一つとても良かったことだなというふうに改めて感じています。で、
We hope that the tourists that have been to South Africa and have experienced our wonderful country really go home with great stories to tell, having been here firsthand and experienced South Africa firsthand. We're a friendly country. We like to go out there and help people and assist people. On a whole, yes, like I said, friendly people. I hope that the tourists go home with a positive impression of South Africa, that and that in the future it encourages people to come and visit our beautiful country.
In the black community, some black community, you know, they really seem still as one of those Afrikaners, those who have oppressed us in this country, you know. But some of the black community people here, you know, those who were in politics, those who know exactly what happened in this country when the negotiations started, they understand what Mr. De Klerk have done. That is very, very important what he's done. Because, you know, what I can say to you, he saved many people's lives from both camps. You know, he saved many, many people's lives. And in the white community, the same. Because some of the Afrikaners, they feel that Mr. De Klerk sold it to the black people. That's why the black people are running the country today. It is because of Mr. De Klerk and all that, and the other guys also, Peg Botha and the others. So they don't regard him as that person. But there are more liberal Afrikaners in this country. They really understand what he did. It was very important, and he was forced to do that, and he had to do it. And it was a positive move that he did today. If you can see the situation in this country.
Whatever good the African World Cup brings, there's a lot of work to be done in Africa. FIFA has done its bit. Now it's for CAF and African associations to step up African football so that the benefits of the World Cup don't go to waste. We need, and some of us are working on, a real African Champions League that's commercially viable, that provides opportunity for our players, the coaches, and more importantly, for the fans to identify with African football. Not Africans playing all over the world. So hopefully, we hope the real legacy of African football is African football being played by Africans in Africa.
Thank you. you know, just taking us through it, the build up, and of course during the tournament, and now just summing it all up. Best of luck.
It's been wonderful to be here, and thank you very much.
The most important thing for me as a South African relative to the World Cup is that it brought a community of nations together. We share and love what they call the beautiful game. So that for me, when humanity and various nations come together for whatever purpose, as long as it's peace, I'm down with that.
The spectacle of football. In the backdrop of the motherland, we hold hands and stand. We stand to celebrate what is the birth of man. Yeah, yeah, yeah. This is the birth. Or should I say the rebirth? Stand up and be a man, Libora. Libora. Sitting Obani. Sitting Obani. Yeah, yeah. Sitting Obani. Yeah. Sitting Obani. Yeah, yeah. There's no place like home, and I yearn to be back. I'm verbally black, but inside I'm turning to that which I once feared. A watered-down version with no spear, no shield, and no sphere of influence. Instead, I'm influenced from all angles. Black, white, Asian, Caribbean, and it's all tangled in a mangled mess. I handle stress in a mixture of ways. Conflicted and blazed, confused by ways in which to behave. No longer a slave to chains, I'm constrained by a reckless freedom. No thought for fellow humans, I'm just a wretch that's breathing, thieving off my own. While the motherland's bleeding from her soul, weeping that her sons have turned to foes. Her eyes closed and tear ducts open. She cries, hoping for the return of her sons and daughters. Her sons and daughters, from lawyers to hospital porters, but all with the same blood pumping through their veins. Sitting Obani, yeah, yeah, yeah. Sitting Obani, yeah, 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 yeah. With the same blood pumping through their veins, something loosens chains, or should I say someone. Undone, the shackles fall as we gather behind the spectacle. The heart's call is meshed into one cry as some die inside, others find life and pride. As the beloved black continent beckons, forgiving our disloyalty, she offers it, and we assume the seat of royalty. Scepter in hand, crown on head, ruled by heart, but by God led. Sitting Obani.